Hi, you're starting to use the Zoho CRM mail merge templates and you don't know how to use the conditions? This video is for you. My name is Alex Weiss at Cornerstone Solutions. I'm going to be showing you how to use the conditions in the mail merge template. Let's start from here. We are inside of the CRM and I created for this purpose here the proposals module. Let's go here. As you go to here to the top right, you have the little gear icon. Let's click over here. In here, you're going to go under customizations to templates. Inside of templates, you have here mail merge. I already created this template here, but I'm going to show you just the first few steps to create a template. Then we go back to this one. Click here, new template. We're going to be choosing the proposals module. Whenever you create a template, keep in mind this template, the mail merge template is going to be associated to a specific module. If you want to try to use another module, you won't be able to see it. Let's give the name for this one just for testing. Proposal sample. We put in the public, you can add the description, you created the template. You have several templates over here. Pre-created, but we normally, like when we are creating, we go to this blank here and click select. When you click select, it launches the writer with Zoho. And here where it's gonna start to build your template. Let's close this one here. Let's step back. I'm gonna just delete this one so we don't get confused. Let's go for the one that I have already created. It's a very simple one, basic. I put even a placeholder text here just to show the how to use the mail merge and the conditions here. Once you're in here, you have the template. You can go and click edit at the top right here. Or if you're in here, let's go back. Let's close these. And let's you see the template here. If you click the little pencil here, it also takes you to the proposal. Okay, we are here. Let's go to back to the CRM here. We did that. Let's go to the proposals. As I mentioned, I created this module and I have one here as an example. It's just basic information. As we are Zoho consultants, I created this proposal for Zoho consulting. It would be a CRM desk, projects or campaigns. We use this structure, but that's a very simple one. We use a very complex structure to create our proposals. And it would be a pleasure to share and show you in more details, you know, if you want to contact us. But now I'm going to do just this basic one here to show you the conditions, which we have the focus here. In this section here, I created proposal details, which I added these pick lists here, just the four as Zoho products, CRM, desk, projects, and campaigns. And here I put like a description for each one. Let's say you're choosing that you wanna do just a proposal for the CRM and you put the information about the proposal here. And let's go back to the proposal there. But before, let me show you one more thing here. We added this section here, details, which just a little blurb here, the placeholder, to show you how it's going to work as well in the proposal template. Let's go back. We're in here. Now you see you have all them here, but let's say you just want to provide, as I showed you there on the proposal section, you just want to share the information for the CRM implementation. And that's how you use conditions. Conditions pretty much, which is this button here, you're going to create a condition that's going to show just the roles that are select in the record. How do you do that? You select, go here to the table. It's a table. And you click the little box here with the number one. And it shows here. Right now, you don't see anything related to the condition. Now, if you come over here and click conditions, it's going to give you this pop-up. You're going to keep the role condition. That's because we're going to be talking about the table row. It's going to be based on the Zoho implementation. Remember, if we go here, we have this field called Zoho implementation. We have Zoho CRM, Zoho Desk, Zoho projects, and campaigns. It's going to be based on this field. Let's go back to proposals. It's a list. You need to check what is the time so it associates correctly. Let's use contains. Just make sure it's going to show exactly what you're looking for. And there you can add CRM here. You could also choose different ones. If it's empty, it's not, begins with, and you can really explore the options here, how to manage that. And you can also use is, but if I would use is here, I would have to type exactly Zoho CRM exactly as we have here. So it wouldn't match if it wasn't correct. Now let's go and insert. Once you insert, you see now you select here, it becomes blue. And if you click here, now you can see this section here. That's the condition. You click, you can come over and see the conditions. You can change it. You can add more conditions if you want. You could just click here. You can use and or. Let's cancel. We are not changing this one. Let's go for the second one. You have this one here, so you don't see the condition. Let's click condition. The same way, let's choose Zoho implementation. It's a list, contains desk. Insert. You see I'm based on the desk field. The third one, let's click condition. So implementation, list, contains, projects. And the last one, the same thing, let's add conditions. So implementation, list, contains, campaign. Okay, now basically this condition, what it does, if you select that list for the CRM, it's going to show this row here and one show the other ones. But we want to add the information for the CRM here. You see this field that I created, Zoho CRM? We're going to go and add here. Now you go to the fields here, the main fields. You have Zoho CRM, you just click here. It adds the connection with the field. Then you go for the next one, desk, projects, and campaigns. It means when you put this connection, the data that is inside of the record in that field is going to show here. This is how it works for the table. Now let's go for a text. Let's say you have in the middle of your text, you want to add some information. Or even here, we want to add details. If it has details, if it's not, we can give another no details or something like that. Now we're going to go and click conditions. It's going to be based on the details field. And it's a multi-line. And we're going to put is not empty. It means if it's not empty, it's going to show. Let's insert. You see how it shows different here? This section here inside, if it's true, it's going to show this section. If it's not, it's going to show this. I put in here before, you can click this little drop down to help you organize. Let's cut this. I'm going to cut this and I'm going to insert in here. And I'm going to put, you see, I put it, this one is typed here, but I'm going to add the details in here. And if it's not, we're going to put no details. And you could go and add these in the middle of the text. So if you're adding dates or something specific about the record, you could go and implement in the whole content. Now let's go. We have implemented all those conditions. Let's go to the proposal. Let's go back here to yellow jersey bikes proposal. You see this one here, I select the CRM, we have the text here, and we have some details. You're gonna go here at the top right, the ellipses, click mail merge. Here you have already the template. Here would show only the templates associated with this module. As I mentioned, templates like mail merge templates are associated with a module. Let's click merge. Once you click merge, it's a process. This first step, it brings the proposal exactly as we did there, no change. But now you're gonna go and go through the process of merging the data from the record to this proposal. You have different ways to do here. I'm not gonna go further on that. Like you have, you can send and merge and send it through email, through sign. We're gonna go and just save as individual file here. That's the option that I'm selecting. Let's click run merge. I'm saving to my library. You keep like a writer document. Here you can also see it has the proposal, can edit, make change here to the name if you need. I'm gonna give just delete that. And proposal, here is gonna be the proposal name. And you can change that. If you go here and select, you can pick whatever information you wanna merge from your record. But let's keep as it is. I'm gonna keep remember, so it stays the same, always does the same as what we are doing here. And let's click create. Now we can click here to view the log. And sometimes it takes a little while, but it's a very small document. It means it should show here pretty quickly. Okay, it's done. You can click here. It's gonna take you to the work drive where I save it. Or you can come over here to the work drive. Let me refresh. Make sure that's the latest one. You see. The proposal that I created is here in work drive in my folders. Now let's click on that. You see, it's only showing the CRM section and the details here that I had, it wasn't empty. Let's see, do another simulation if you want to see. If you go to the proposal, let's change now to projects. And save. We can leave this one here, but let's cut this one. It's not based. Let's put in projects. Let's just delete. Save. And let's delete the details here. Okay. Let's go through the process again. You go to the top right, you have the ellipses here. You click mail merge. You have the proposals, click merge. The same way you see it's showing the as it is as the template. Let's scroll down, click run merge. You see if it's the same settings that I did before because I saved, you don't need to save again at this point. Let's just click create. You can skip it to view log. You can always go to directly to the location where you saved. Let's click refresh. Okay, we have the second one here. That's the new one. As we click here, you see now you show projects and it shows no details. Okay, that's the overall idea how to use conditions. It can be very helpful if you're putting together a proposal. It can be a long proposal. Our proposal is over 23 pages, the template, and it varies from client to client. It goes up and down, and it can help us to do a proposal that normally would take us 2 hours or 3 hours, depending how complex it is. We can do in 30 to 40, 45 minutes, something like that. Thank you for your time. That's it for today.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.